First pitch to MacDonald, rifled out to his right. Left fielder's going to stop Stevens.
The turnaround took a couple of steps, but he knew where it was going.
You've got to be really careful.
He might be giving that one up. This one hit deep to right. First time this year, back-to-back shots.
Welcome back, Moondogs fans. Episode 14 of Off the Leash. Today, I have a special guest, 2018 Moondog Kyle MacDonald. Kyle led the league in homers and RBIs during his stay in Mankato. Kyle, how are you doing? Looks a little cold.
It is a little cold, and you know, it is what it is. But it's fitting. I'm in an Off the Leash podcast while I'm walking my dog, so you know, it works out.
Yeah. So let's talk a little bit, I guess, about what led up to your Mankato days. So you played at Arkansas State. You obviously got drafted by Arkansas State into the Yankees, but you know, I was looking at the numbers and you played a full season at Arkansas State and then went to the Northwoods and played a full season there. How was that?
Yeah, that was, it was a little different. It was a lot of ball, that's for sure. You know, it was kind of those things I had heard about the Northwoods League. I heard it was a lot and I heard it was a grind, this and that. And I had buddies who played in it, but I'd also heard that if, you know, I wanted to get drafted and I wanted to play at the next level, that was going to be my best bet. And
yeah,
I was like, you know what? I didn't leave home at 18 to go down to the U.S. And I guess it was Crowder College, Missouri at the time, the JUCO I went to. And, you know, I didn't do all that just to, you know, I could have got a degree up here, right? My goal was to get drafted and play pro ball. And so I said, if I got one shot at it, I'm going to go do it. And, you know, it was a lot, but it was a lot of fun as well. And, you know, it all worked out, I guess they say.
Yeah. You know, like I had said earlier, you led the league in home runs and RBIs. You also had 15 doubles, 16 home runs was the official total, and 75 RBIs. You obviously played a lot of games, but, you know, was there anything different from your approach at Arkansas State compared to Mankato, where you're playing with, you know, wood bats every day?
Yeah, a little bit. Being from Canada, we actually started playing with wood. I want to say 13 or 14. So going back to the wood wasn't too big of an issue, because I had been used to it in high school. It was actually probably more of a change going to the aluminum bats in college than anything. But it wasn't even that much I was necessarily changing my approach, but I was learning a lot. You know, just talking to the guys down there, like guys I played with, like Brandon Fatt, who's going to big league camp with the Diamondbacks in a month. And, you know, a bunch of Garrett Mitchell was down there, and, you know, Kevin Lucas, a lot of big-time arms and big-time players. And guys that we could all just bounce ideas off of. You know, I talked to them about, how would you face me in this situation? Or, you know, what pitch would you throw me here? What would you do after that at bat? Or, you know, this or that. And then they would do the same, you know, pitchers that, you know, what are you looking for in this situation? Why'd he beat me there? This or that. And you kind of just change off of that. It gives you new ideas. Like, oh, okay, maybe that's why he threw that pitch in that situation.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not going to let him do that again this time, because I know what he did last time. And, you know, it's just the game within the game and little mind things. And, you know, just trying to get a little bit better and bouncing ideas off guys.
Yeah.
To play at the highest level like that always helps, right?
Yeah. You talked about, you know, how you played with a lot of guys who got drafted. And Garrett Mitchell specifically just debuted with the Brewers. He's a top prospect. That was a good team, too. You guys went 46-26. Kind of just, I guess, talk about your experience on the team and just being around those type of players.
Yeah, I mean, well, it's one thing. I mean, everyone kind of sees, you know, the talent on the field, and, you know, it was kind of obviously our record and the numbers we put up kind of speak for ourselves there. But the team we had off the field is what made that whole summer. You know, everyone says the Northwoods League's a grind and it's tough and it's this and it's that. And they weren't kidding. They, you know, they were right. It is. But when you had a team like we had, you know, we were so close. You know, off days we still spent together. We'd get done after games and, you know, we'd go out and we'd go eat together. We'd go have a drink together. We, you know, on the bus rides, we all played games and we weren't, you know, no one hated each other. No one, there's no fights. There's no arguments. And, you know, you can make a long summer even longer when you're not getting along, right? But when you got a group full of guys that, you know, everyone is kind of embracing the suck together, right? Like everyone's like, oh, man, we got a 15-hour bus ride tomorrow. But it was like, all right, like, what are we going to do on this 15-hour bus ride? It's going to make it suck a little bit less.
Yeah, right? Fair enough. Yeah.
So it was one of those things. Like, we had a really good group of guys, and the coaching staff was great that year as well. It kind of let us do our thing as well, and, you know, wasn't too miserable.
Yeah. Once you left Mankato, obviously, then the next year you got drafted out of Arkansas State. You got drafted by the Yankees in the 27th round. You know, going into pro ball, where there are a lot of similarities between, you know, the schedule in the Northwoods compared to your schedule in pro ball?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, obviously, that's, I think, the goal of the Northwoods, right, is to kind of prepare you for the next level. And it definitely did. I mean, playing in the Northwoods and then going in my first year of pro ball, I got hurt not too long after the draft, and I kind of missed a lot of that short season and then put a little bit in the GCL at the end of the year there. But, you know, at the GCL, it's you play your games at 10 in the morning, 11 o'clock in the morning, and it's 100 degrees in, you know, Florida, and it's miserable.
Yeah.
But, you know, it's very similar to the Northwoods, right? Like, you get up and you get on a bus, you get off the bus, you play, and you get back on, you go home. And, yeah. And at the low levels of the minor leagues, it's the exact same thing, right? It's not until you get a little higher up that you get to start traveling and ahead of time and taking the nicer buses and flying once you get to AAA and stuff, right? So,
yeah.
Northwoods definitely did a good job.
Yeah. And, you know, talking about that team you were on, was there a favorite teammate or a guy you really connected with on that team?
Yeah, I mean, there was a few guys. I mean, Jake Shepsky and I were real close. He kind of helped me a lot with, you know, a lot of things he had done before as far as the All-Star game and the Dream Showcase and stuff like that he had already done, right? So I was able to talk to him, like, man, like, is it worth my time going? Are there actually scouts there? Are they just blowing this thing up, you know? Like, how do I prepare myself to go play in this All-Star game and have no off days while everyone else is sitting around for 3 days at the lake, right?
Yeah.
So he was really good about a lot of that. Jake and I, you know, we send each other a little message here and there every now and then still. And Kyle Cuellar was a good buddy. He hung out with us too. Garrett Mitchell, Evan Klugerman. Nick Novak. The list could go on and on, honestly. I'd probably say Shepsky and I were pretty close on the team together. But I mean, I could just about everybody on that team. Nick Belzer, Ricky DeGrugier.
Yeah.
He was a bunch of boys.
Yeah. You talked about the travel a little bit. Was there a favorite spot you had to play in the Northwoods League outside of ISG Field?
ISG Field was amazing. I love playing in Mankato. That was the fans, the atmosphere, everything like that was great. But outside of there, oh man, where do we go? I'm trying to think. Maybe Fond du Lac. Fond du Lac had a nice little field. Probably off the top of my head, I'm gonna say there. What's the team up in North Dakota? I didn't like traveling
Bismarck.
There.
Bismarck.
Hated traveling there, but the actual like facilities and like playing field was actually not too bad. But the travel, oh my god.
Yeah, going all the way up there.
Yeah, it wasn't worth it.
Yeah. Is there a specific experience that, you know, you went through when you were in Mankato that you kind of look back as like your proudest moment, your happiest moment as Moondog?
Yeah. I mean, I got a lot of memories off the field there. I mean, going out on the lakes and the boats and, you know, hanging out with the guys. But on the field, I guess if I had to think, probably my favorite moment from that summer is probably the walk-off against Thunder Bay at home.
Okay.
The walk-off home run. I think that's my only walk-off home run. I've had a few walk-off singles, doubles, whatever, but
first walk-off
that was run. That was a fun moment, especially to do it, you know, in front of a crowd like that, everyone into it, and then a situation like that. That was a lot of fun for sure. That's one I always look back on.
Your only walk-off home run ever to come in Mankato. That's a pretty cool moment.
Yeah, I'm like 99.9% sure is the only walk-off one I have ever hit.
You know, talking back to that team, I mean, you guys were obviously really good, played the entire regular season. Was there a team that you kind of went back and forth with all year, had a little bit of a rivalry with?
Yeah, that year, probably, we had a little thing. I want to say it was Bismarck. I think we beat us in the first round of playoffs too, but I don't know, for some reason, us and them, as far as I remember, didn't get along as great. A lot of the teams in the league were pretty chill. Like, we play a hard battle game, and then you might see him out that night, or, you know, we became friends with a lot of the guys who play him a bunch. And some of the guys we played against, actually, some of the Bismarck guys, Matt Workington and some of those guys, like, still, you know, keep in touch with on Instagram and here and there. And so, honestly, a lot of the teams were pretty cool. But Bismarck, I want to say we kind of kind of was the one team that we didn't really get along with the most that summer, probably.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, last question. You know, when you think about playing for that type of team and playing in Mankato, kind of what was your reflection on the whole experience playing there?
Oh, it was great. I always tell people, like, I've lived in so many different places, the Arkansas, Missouri, across Canada, Minnesota, wherever, for summer ball, baseball, et cetera. But I love Mankato. Mankato is one of my favorite places I've lived in. My host family, I had the Dykemans, and they were phenomenal. You know, they were unbelievable. Everything about Mankato was great. The fans, they made everything just feel like home. You know, I didn't feel out of place there at all. And then I went straight back to school and just kept right back into it. And
yeah.
Coaching staff was great. Ryan Craig and those guys. I mean, it was that summer was one of my favorite summer ball, probably my favorite summer ball experience of my summer balls. Even though it was probably the toughest and the biggest grind.
Yeah.
You know, obviously playing well that summer helps the experience. You know, crossing 210 was a home run. I'd probably not be as happy about the situation. But when you play good and you have a bunch of good guys around you and good coaching staff and everything, it makes the summer a lot more fun and everything go by a lot quicker and a lot easier. So I loved my time there for sure. And I'd love to go back to Mankato for a weekend or so at some point and catch a series or something.
Yeah. Well, yeah. Yeah. Thank you, Kyle, today for joining Off the Leash podcast. This was episode 14. Kyle MacDonald joined us today. Kyle, thank you for your time.
Yeah, thanks, man. Thanks for having me. It was great. And best of luck this year.